So. This episode really got me thinking that things are starting to turn around in the Star Wars universe. That one scene with Luke. Kind of changed the name of the game in a way. And now that door's been unlocked, there are some things I would like to see going forward. If we can get a young Luke series, I think maybe you can get back to where we should have been by now on the films. At the same time, this is a younger version of Luke, so older Luke would not be able to move like this. Know what I mean? This ain't possible. I mean, he gets more powerful as he ages, but there are subtle differences. Like, I've been watching that scene over and over again, and he has a similar fighting style to Anakin, but unlike Anakin, he doesn't really use his anger like Anakin would. Anakin would have been way more aggressive with his fighting style and whatnot. See, Luke is supposed to be everything Anakin was not. That's why Yoda says, "You're the last of the Jedi. Last of the old, first of the new." Which brings me to this. See, this Luke that we see in Mandalorian finale, that's expanding universe Luke Skywalker. You understand? That's Jedi Master Luke from the books. Comics like this, Dark Empire. Books like this. Now granted, the CGI was definitely noticeable. It's impossible not to notice it. But putting that aside, obviously get a real actor if you're going to do a Luke Skywalker series. I mean, sure hope they do. It's kind of a waste in my opinion if they don't. After that? You kidding me? You don't just give people a spectacle like that and then say, oh, well, we put him in one scene, so now we're not going to give him a series. Like, please, do it. I think by now he recently won the fans, at least some of his back. I'm intrigued. I'll say that much. I'm not putting all my eggs in the basket yet, because Disney does this stuff all the time. You get everybody riled up, and then they do something stupid. I've been doing this since episode 7. So, yeah. I'm intrigued, I'm impressed, but decent. It's a good episode. Solid episode. But the Luke stuff really was great. I'm not looking down at it at all. I'm just looking at this from a different perspective like I usually do. And, again, for a young Luke Skywalker series, there are some improvements to be made. Face thing especially. It's kind of distracting when he's talking. If you ignore the speech thing he does, going on the movements in the hallway, the fighting in the hallway, the way he moved, the way he swung his saber and all that. Beautiful. Really beautiful. So I gotta give a shout out to Dave Filoni and John Favreau. Well done, gentlemen. Now, Favreau, I don't really know that well as far as his directing chops. Filoni, a little more familiar with, because George Lucas handpicked him to be his protege. But this whole show was Favreau's idea, from what I understand. So, yeah. Kudos to you, Mr. Favreau. You're doing a great job with the show so far. personally have no interest in a Boba Fett show like down here. But like, if they announce a Luke Skywalker series, I might just lose it again. Like I lost it during this episode, and like, I know how much sleep I lost watching that scene over and over again. Starting to doze off. Like, I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, now can we get Mara Jade into the Star Wars universe, please? Mara Jade, the real Jason, the real Ben, Jaina. There's no excuse now. You got a young Luke kicking all kinds of ass. Post turn Jedi. Mara Jade is alive in this time period. So if you're gonna do Legacy of the Force or some version of that, do it now. It's up to me. I cancel that Boba Fett show. Who cares what that guy does? Who cares? I would cancel the Boba Fett show and replace it with a Luke Skywalker series. It's something I'm just putting this out there. I'm willing to bet more people will be interested in Luke Skywalker over some crappy bounty hunter that never had a character to begin with. Since the freaking 80s. For whatever reason, some people seem to be excited or whatever. Why? Don't know. I don't get it. This is one of my favorites, Legacy of the Force. This is the series finale of Legacy of the Force, Invincible, when Jaina confronts Darth Kytus. She killed him, but spoilers. Yeah, Darth Kytus died. She killed him. She was always more powerful than Jason. But, yeah, she killed him. There was no winner. I think Jason hesitated. And she took him out. Took him out. Did the one thing Kenobi could never do back in the Revenge of the Sith. And Luke named her Sword of the Jedi. Man, I would love this. I would love to see Jaina in live action. Jason. We got Luke already. Deal with you talking about Sebastian Stan playing young Luke. I'm like, eh. Before this, I would have said no. Now I'm like, do it. Do it. If not him, because someone looks like him. Because if I was an actor, I would say he looks just like the guy. Looks just like Mark Hamill. See, I don't think the CGI was necessary. I think they could have pulled it off with the guy that had a similar hairstyle and whatnot. I'd just give him a friggin' wig. But again, it's like I always say, they're so scared of fan reaction that they just keep doing all this dumb stuff. It's unnecessary. I say it all the time. They're still scared. But I think the ropes are loosening. And things are starting to look up. So I'm pleased with that. Like, I always said, maybe in earlier videos, that Disney should have definitely recast the original characters with younger actors. So we could tell fresh stories, like Legacy of the Force, or Dark Empire. Because, skip, you wait 30 friggin' years, and they didn't do anything interesting with these classic characters in the quote unquote sequel trilogy. Trilogy has stunk. And now, never gonna get Harrison Ford back. And then, I can't blame the guy, honestly. But, could do some things now if you get the right young cast recast Han Solo again, please. Get rid of Aldrich or whatever the hell his name is. And get Anthony Gruber to play Han Solo. I don't know who could play young Leia, but I'm sure there's someone out there that could pull it off. See, now they can do this. Before this, people would have been nervous. Now they can do this. Now they can experiment. This is a good test run. And now they can do it. I have more confidence in them now. At least in Filoni and Favreau. As long as Empress Wrinkles stays the frick away. Doesn't put her greedy hands where they don't belong. And keep her stupid politics out of Star Wars. Stay away. I'm excited for the future of Star Wars. I don't care about Boba Fett series or whatever hell it's called. I didn't hear about this post-credit scene until after I watched the episode. And naturally I turned it off. I didn't bother going back to look because I don't care about that stupid character. I don't care. But Luke Skywalker series, yeah. I'm definitely down for that.